In this video, we're going to demonstrate how to use the Dolby Vision Trim controls in DaVinci Resolve Studio. These trim controls are a set of modifiers that lets you adjust and refine the mapping to other HDR targets as well as an SDR target. To unlock the trim controls, you need a license from Dolby. If you have a Dolby Vision Trim license loaded, you will notice that additional trim controls become active as soon as you perform the analysis. Once the Dolby Vision analysis is done, it is highly recommended that you check the mapping beginning with the SDR target. Start trimming the SDR mapped version by selecting the 100 nit BT709 BT1886 target from the target display output dropdown inside the Dolby Vision tab. Make sure to select 100 nit BT709 BT1886 full for both the target display output and the trim controls for. Ensure that your reference display and scopes are set to match these SDR settings as well. The Dolby Vision Trim controls in version 4 offer both primary and secondary controls to adjust the mapping for the selected target display output. Dolby Vision version 4 allows you to offset the initial analysis using the mid-tone offset control. This control is useful for matching the overall exposure of the mapped image to the HDR master. It acts as an offset to the L1 mid values and adjusts the mid-tones of the image without affecting the blacks and highlights. It is important to note that this offset is applied globally to the shot and will affect the mapping at all targets for the shot. The mid-tone offset is recorded as level 3 metadata. It is recommended to first trim the mapped output with the mid-tone offset control and obtain a better starting point before adding additional primary and secondary trims. Let's now move over to the primary trim controls and have a look at the various trim options. Do remember that the primary and secondary trims apply only to a selected target, unlike the global mid-tone offset. Lift, gamma, and gain are designed to work like traditional lift, gamma, and gain controls in the color corrector. Due to the current implementation of signal transmission over HDMI, the Dolby Vision mapping on some devices is not constrained to the active image area, but instead is applied to the entire image. This can cause the letterbox or blanking area to have elevated black levels during playback. Consequently, avoid using positive lift values over 0.025 on letterbox content. Higher values can cause the letterboxed area to have elevated black levels during playback. Lift values below 0.025 do not cause this effect. If the image aspect ratio matches the canvas aspect ratio, so there is no letterbox, positive lift can be used without constraints. Saturation gain adjusts the overall saturation of the mapped image. Chroma weight trim helps preserve color saturation in the upper mid-tones and highlight areas, especially when mapping down from HDR to SDR. Tone detail trim restores sharpness only in the highlight areas of the mapped image. Mid contrast bias compresses and stretches the image around the mid-tone region and can increase or decrease contrast in the mid-tones of the mapped image. The highlight clipping trim reduces or limits details in the highlights by clipping them as required. The secondary 6-vector saturation and hue controls allow colorists to adjust the saturation and the hue of the mapped image individually. These controls are especially useful when trying to fit or shift the wide color gamut of P3 or Rec 2020 into the limited color gamut of Rec 709 SDR. Both primary and secondary trim values are stored as level 8 metadata in Dolby Vision version 4.0. You may choose to create trims for SDR only, but you could also add additional trims for other targets, like 600 nits HDR. However, as the trims interpolate across all targets, it's advised to start trimming the 100 nit SDR version first, and then continue with other targets. Trims made at 100 nit SDR also affect higher luminance targets. The Dolby Vision trim controls offer you a creative option that can be applied on as many shots as needed. Use the option menu in the Dolby Vision palette to copy and paste trim metadata. Resolve also lets you copy and paste analysis metadata. However, analysis metadata should be calculated individually for each shot and copied from one shot to another only for very specific use cases. In addition to adjusting the trim controls via the user interface, you can also use Resolve's advanced control panel as well as third-party MIDI controllers to modify the trims. Once you have finished your trims, review the mapped output. If you have other targets, select a new target display output and the corresponding trim controls, and review the mapped output for each target and trim as needed.